Nau mai, haere mai I te whānau o Waiopehu. Welcome to Waiopehu College's 2021 Senior Prize Giving. I invite Sione to give the karakia to start our afternoon.
By your heads, let's pray. Atoa koe mauta mai tai ngata ai a Fiona, oku mau whakawhetai, pea moe whakamaloa atu ki a te koe, I hele lei katoa pē kua ke fuaki o whakateonga aki ki mautolo. Maloha o tauhi, o fwaki, mai ai poto mai ilo, ke mau I nasi ai. Oku mau whakafoki, atu ai gloria, mai langilangi, ke kei whakateonga aki ai a Fiona. Oku mau whakamalo, atu e tamai, e mea katoa pē, e mau maui. Ai poto mai ilo, o whakafou, mai I he kau whaiako. E o tua oku mau luwa atu e mau maui, ke kei whaipē, ho mau tauhi, I a sisu karasi, ko ho mau whakamaui. Amen.
This afternoon is a celebration of student success, and it's wonderful to be sharing this with you via our live stream. Thank you for watching. Ko Brunia Porini Tuku Ingwa, and I've had the privilege of being head girl this year.
Ko Tiaki Tuku Ingwa, and I've been proud to be head boy this year. We will be your MCs for today. We would like to acknowledge our special guests who would normally attend to present awards and support our students' successes. Due to the current situation, we are unable to have guests at prize giving. However, the ongoing support of those who provide for our students is greatly appreciated. A reminder too that after the ceremony, all prize winners are invited to share a light afternoon tea in the canteen. Prize winners are also able to have their photograph taken in the auditorium foyer.
This afternoon, we will see several types of academic awards given out. Attainment awards are awarded for significant effort and/or achievement in a subject. Service awards are for students who have demonstrated reliable, dedicated service to an aspect of college life outside their timetable classes.
Many of these were already given out at our merit assembly. Those students receiving attainment and service awards tonight are either winning three or more, or they are receiving other awards as well.
Outstanding achievement awards are for exceptional academic performance in a subject. Only a small percentage of students can earn outstanding achievement.
First in class awards are for the top performing student in a subject. Some subjects have trophies or prizes for the top student instead.
Some students will earn a principal's award for academic excellence. This is for students who have earned not only a lot of excellence credits, but a high proportion of all their credits at excellence. Students earning this award have all demonstrated extremely hard work, high academic ability, and dedication to achieving outstanding academic success in all of their subjects.
Finally, our special awards celebrate a range of different achievements, from sport to service and cultural to achievement, a cultural achievement to academic success. These include a range of scholarships with a combined value of over $100,000.
We will also celebrate Dean's Awards, appoint next year's House Leaders, celebrate our Year 13 leavers, and we will find out the makeup of our student executive team for 2022, including finding out who will follow in our footsteps as head students.
First, please welcome Waiopehu College Board of Trustees Chairperson, Mr. Gareth Marshall, whose speech has been pre-recorded.
Kia ora koutou. Kei Gareth Marshall, tōku ingoa. Yes, I'm the presiding member of the Waiopehu School Board. And sorry I can't join you today, but I do want to just say a couple of things at this graduation and prize giving ceremony. And I have sympathy because my daughter is in year 13 this year, and know that the way that this year has worked out and what is happening is difficult for everyone, and takes away something that people have been looking to or forward to for 5 years of a graduation in a different way, and not being able to celebrate with family and friends is difficult. I just want to take the opportunity to say thank you to our senior leadership team at school this year. As per last year, this year has not been any easier. And it's been a difficult year, and I just want to say thank you to Mark, Allison and Guy for what you've done, for the way that you've led the school through these challenging times, and really appreciate it. And on behalf of of all students and their families, thank you for the way that you've led and led by example. I want to also pay appreciation to our staff who continue to be dedicated, who have continued to work hard, who have continued to walk alongside our students to give them the best educational opportunities, even though that, you know, the trips have been different this year or not been able to happen. We've had to cancel things. We've had to do learning from home, and our teachers have worked hard to make sure that everyone and all of our students have the opportunity to succeed and to get across the line and to get the results that they can and that they deserve. I also want to acknowledge my fellow members on the board, and thank you for what you do, your commitment to the school, the passion that you give, and the discussions that we have around the boardroom table. And I'm proud to be one of you, and proud of the decisions that we've made to make our Waiopehu school the school that it is, and the improving school that we continue to be. And there's been some exciting decisions this year, and some tough decisions as well, when we had to make calls around cancelling events and that sort of thing. None of the decisions are taken lightly. They are fully discussed and talked out, all under wanting the best for our children. It's been exciting this year, a decision we made late last year to introduce school lunches and do it in-house, and I'm proud to be part of the board that made the decision, and the school lunches have made a huge contribution this year to our students, and it's been well received, and it's been a great asset to the school, and we have a great team, and it's exciting to see that the project of the cafe space almost up and running, ready to go, which is going to just even be more exciting next year. And finally, to our Year 13 students, well, this is it, 5 years at Waiopehu for many of you, the end of this journey and the end of the season in your life. This year has been a challenging time, and many things that you were looking forward to you haven't been able to do. As someone once told me, in every challenge there is an opportunity. Easy to say, a lot harder to do, but when you come across challenge, look for the opportunities that present themselves, because there always will be some. As I say, all good things take time, and challenge just makes us a better person. So it has been a tough year. Thank you for the way that you have been during this year. Thank you for the way you've acted. Thank you that you've got on with the job and still being determined to get the results that you deserve, ready for your new journey that starts next year. Don't forget that success isn't an individual thing. Success only comes about when we surround ourselves with good people and good mentors and people that give us good advice, even when it's advice that we don't want to hold. And as you go out next year on your journey and the next start and the next part of your life, make sure you surround yourself with good friends. Hold on to the friendships that you've done over the last 5 years at school. But for those that move away or need to get new friend groups, look for the right people to put around you, because success is never a lone feat. You need others to help you get to where you want to go. And I've always found that the good results and good success comes from a multitude of little decisions, not the big decision that we stress and get anxious over. So thank you for your time. Thank you for what you've done. Sorry we can't be there as family and friends. We would have loved to celebrate this day with you. And thank you to everyone in the community that makes Waiopehu for what it is. It's a privilege to serve this school. Appreciate it.
Thank you, Gareth. I would now like to invite our principal, Mr. Mark Robinson, to deliver his principal's address.
Thank you very much. Tuia I runga, tuia I raro, tuia I roto, tuia I waho, tuia te heri tangata, ka ranga te pō, karanga te ao, tihe Māori ora. Tēnā koutou, tēnā koutou, tēnā koutou katoa. Piki mai, kaki mai, ki tēnei taumata whakanuia o te koratua rua o Waiopehu. Ko Mark Robinson toko ingoa, nō reira, nō mai haere mai. To all our staff and students, I offer you a very warm welcome to Prize Giving 2021, where we are gathered to celebrate the many successes of our senior students and to also farewell our graduating Year 13s. A huge congratulations to all our award winners and this afternoon, and a massive thank you to our award presenters and sponsors for the generous support they provide by way of scholarships and prizes. I would like to start by taking a moment to remember one of our foundation staff members, Mr. Colin Hagen, who passed away in October this year, aged 82. He started as deputy principal when the school first opened in 1973 and was then principal from 1981 to 1989. He was much loved by everyone who knew him, and he is widely remembered as being kind, compassionate, and deeply committed to Waiopehu College, to the students, and to the wider community. Colin was also a massive supporter of sports, culture, and the arts, and he was head of basketball during his time here. We send all our love and best wishes to his family. This is a prize giving with a very different flavour, as you've just heard from our presiding member of the board, Mr. Gareth Marshall. We are operating under the guidelines of a COVID world, and where we are not able to welcome whānau, guests, and other supporters of our kura. However, this event is being live streamed, and I therefore offer a very warm welcome to all our viewers watching live online, or perhaps catching up on all the action at a later date. Thank you for your support, and do enjoy what I know is going to be a fabulous celebration of our students' achievements this afternoon. I began last year's prize-giving address by celebrating some amazing NCEA results, and once again, our 2021 NCEA results are tracking well despite the interference of COVID-19. In fact, however you choose to measure success, whether it be academic, in sport, through culture, or engaging in a meaningful pathway to further training or employment upon leaving college, we remain strong. I would like to take this opportunity to thank on your behalf our fabulous board of trustees, Kirsten McKenzie, John Nicholson, Dave Stout, Grit Schlois, Jackie Kerens, Lavalia Fanotti, Charlotte Schlois, Aroha Pako, Heke New, and the presiding board member, Gareth Marshall. The board has an unswerving passion for Waiopehu College, and they are committed to providing high quality governance for our community. We are hugely indebted to you all. This afternoon, though, is a time of celebration, an occasion where we see the results of all the hard work that got our amazing students to this point. It is also a time of thanks, where we acknowledge all those who have helped make graduation a reality for each member of the Year 9 class of 2017. Can I just pause at this point to say on behalf of the staff a really big thank you to Year 13. As always each year, we always get a little bit nervous when we worry about, or wonder perhaps, about what your leaving prank might be. And over the years, we've had some very good ones. But today, I thought Year 13s, you did a fantastic job. Thank you for decorating our staff room so wonderfully and welcoming us this morning with positive messages, chocolates and biscuits. It was much appreciated. And thank you also to those who helped clean up. Good on you. Inevitably, the end of a school year, though, does bring some farewells to departing staff, and I would like to acknowledge those staff at this point. So firstly, I would like to wish Mrs. Colette Kyle all the very best with her study leave next year. She's not technically leaving, as she will be back in 2023. And we also look forward to welcoming back Mrs. Sarah Anoka, who is teaching both maths and digital technology next year. As you may also be aware, Mrs. Court Kelly is currently on maternity leave, and we look forward to welcoming her back to Waiopehu in October 2022. I would next like to acknowledge Helen Gordon, who has worked with us since 2016 in the Home Economics Department. She is the one who makes sure the shopping is done, and she does a huge amount to help in the smooth running of the team. We wish Helen well as she now looks forward to spending more time with family. Mrs. Natasha Artoon joined us only this year in a fixed term role, and she made such a positive impact, we offered her a permanent position. She has done some fabulous work as part of the English department, and she was a wonderful member of the staff team supporting our Pacifica students in the Fa'atasi Poly Group. Despite this, Natasha will sadly be leaving us this year due to family commitments, but we do thank her hugely for everything she has contributed to Waiopehu College in her short time here. We next farewell Mrs. Abby Quinn for the second time. Abby started her teaching career with us before teaching over in the UK, and she enjoyed Waiopehu so much, she returned to us in 2021. She is a brilliant teacher and dean, and we are really going to miss her energy and enthusiasm around our kura. Abby, though, lives in Fielding, which is a very long commute, so she simply couldn't turn down a position at Fielding High School, which is literally 5 minutes from her front door. Thanks, Abby, for all you have given to Waiopehu, and a special thank you for arranging the landing of a Royal New Zealand Air Force NH-90 helicopter on our school field. Certainly one memory many of us will never forget. We next farewell Fire Grace Taniora, who is moving to Auckland with her whānau. Grace was born and raised in Taitoko, so after many years commuting daily to Porirua, it was like coming home when she started as head of Māori at Waiopehu in 2018. Grace has really helped grow and deepen our relationship with Mua Upoko to the point where we are about to relaunch our Ohu Whānau Rupu later this term. And Mua Upoko Tanga is now embedded in her teaching programs. But most importantly, Grace cares deeply for her students. And you only have to look at the number of rangatahi who congregate in Tika Aroha at intervals and lunchtimes to know how much aroha everyone has for her. Grace now takes up an exciting new role as education manager at Te Wānanga o Aotearoa in Auckland, which is a quite brilliant achievement. Grace, whai a te iti kahorangi ki te tuoho koe, me he maonga teitei. Seek the treasure you value most dearly. If you bow your head, let it be to a lofty mountain. Ngā mihi nui e hoa. We next farewell Mrs. Karen Gill, who is retiring after joining Waiopehu College in 2009. She has been an outstanding teacher, and as well as growing successful young people, she has led the professional development of beginning teachers over many years. Karen is the epitome of a great teacher and colleague. She always maintains high standards. She has high expectations of her students and her colleagues. She has a deep understanding of what works in education. And she has grown the social sciences and health curriculum areas significantly in her time here. None of us really want to see Mrs. Gill leave us, but she has definitely earned her retirement, along with the chance to spend more time with family and friends. Thank you, Karen, for the amazing contribution you have made to our school and to this community. We will miss you, and we wish you only the very best for your future. Mrs. Anne Kirk joined us from Horowhenua College in 2004, and has taught English and has been head of ESOL during that time. She has always had a passion for supporting students where English is their second language, and hundreds of young people have gone on to excel in their learning both at school, in tertiary education, and in the community thanks to Anne's dedication. She now moves to Northland to be closer to her family, and we wish her all the very best for the future. And one brief example, if I may just interject with an example there, is a young man called Fiamaki, who arrived in New Zealand only a few years ago with very little English. This year, he is achieving level one at NCEA with over 90 credits, I understand, and may well be leaving us, but has done an amazing job during that time. So thank you, Mrs. Kirk, for helping not only Fiamaki, but all sorts of students along the way. Thank you. Finally, and with a heavy heart, we farewell Mrs. Pam Skirman, who is retiring after 34 years dedicated service to Waiopehu College. Just let that sink in for a moment. 34 years teaching and inspiring thousands of students in the areas of typing, computing, and music. Mrs. Skirman is very special to me and my family, as she was my daughter Charlie's tutor teacher for 5 years until Charlie left at the end of last year. I thought I'd ask Charlie to help me describe Mrs. Skirman, and this is what she said. She was like my school mum. Cut that bit out, Tim. She's kind, caring, nice, lovely, fun to talk to. She has a great sense of humour, and she's always excited to see you. Mrs. Skirman always tries really hard to make her tutor group feel like a family, and I know she does this with all her classes. We would share our accomplishments and be proud of each other. And she also loves the colour purple. I think this is quite a wonderful description of quite an amazing person. And may you head into retirement, Pam, with all our love and very best wishes for a long and happy road ahead. Could we please give all our departing staff a huge round of applause? Our 650 or so amazingly talented and unique students are always at the forefront of my mind. In every action or decision I make as a principal, I always ask the same question: how is this adding value to an individual student or to the collective student body? And we have amazing students here at Waiopehu. They are thoughtful, passionate, loud, quiet, honest, funny, empathetic, energetic, loyal, and totally unique. Each student contributes in their own way to the tapestry and layers of our school, and I would like to thank each and every one of you for your unique contribution in 2021. Without you all, our school would simply not be the same. Our staff in each of their areas right across the school have also been incredible in what has once again been a challenging year. At all times, our teachers have demonstrated an incredible mix of determination, passion, professionalism, patience, and persistence. Together with support staff, they have once again weaved their magic and influenced students' lives for the better. The things I value the most about the staff at Waiopehu are their unwavering optimism, positivity, and genuine care for each and every young person. They just get on and do what needs to be done. And for this and for your work this year, I sincerely thank you all. I would also personally like to thank our fabulous senior leadership team, Guy Reichenbach and Alison Spencer. And this year we have been ably supported by Lois Marshall and Karen Gill. The sense of family that we have at Waiopehu continues to be driven by the inclusive and highly relational leadership, both from this amazing team, as well as from our fabulous wider pastoral network. And I'm indebted to you for all that you do day in and day out to ensure our students get the very best education possible. No one else really gets to see and appreciate the work you all put in behind the scenes, the pace at which you have to complete that work, and the unwavering dedication you all have to do in what is best for our students. Thank you for all that you do, and a very special thanks to Mr. Guy Reichenbach for masterminding this prize-giving ceremony today. Although Mr. Reiki has been at Waiopehu since 2007, this is the first time he has organized prize giving. Ms. Sherlock would be proud. Well done, sir, on an outstanding job. Our student executive leadership team, along with our house leaders, have once again stepped up brilliantly this year, and I know we all look forward to being introduced to our new student leaders later on this afternoon. At this point, I would like to sincerely thank our head students, Tiaki Hinani and Brania Parimi, deputy head students, Elijah Bathan and Oriana Enuka, as well as Ashley, Georgia, Josh, Kate, Keely, Lavalier, Mary, Octavia, Sione, and Toby, our student executive for 2021. You have all given an incredible amount of dedicated service to the school, not just this year, but during your total time here. Don't underestimate the influence and impact you have here on our young people at Waiopehu. And in a year where your leadership style has had to once again adapt and change, you have stepped up and you have delivered. My personal and heartfelt thanks to you all. I do want to particularly recognize the outstanding service of our head students, Brenia and Tiaki. They have led their school with pride and their total commitment to making a difference for students, for the wider community, and to the school environment has been outstanding. I know it has been really hard this year to see so many events you were leading having to be cancelled or postponed, but you have taken on the challenge of leading the student body through a second COVID year, and you have been inspirational to us all. As a token of our appreciation for everything you have done this year and during your time at Waiopehu, please accept these taonga with our love and best wishes. If I could ask our head students just to stand for a moment. Most importantly, this afternoon is all about the fantastic achievements of our students. Many congratulations to each and every one of you receiving an award. You all have one thing in common. That is that you have worked hard and you have reached your goal. I truly believe that success is an attitude. You have demonstrated that and you have been duly rewarded. You should all be very proud of your achievements. Thank you also to our parents, to our caregivers and whānau, many of whom are watching via our live stream. You are the unsung heroes who have provided unconditional love, support and encouragement that has enabled your sons and daughters to thrive. Learning is a three-way partnership between school, home and students, and you too are to be congratulated on the achievements we are celebrating this afternoon. To our new student executive team, I want you to begin your journey with the following whakatauki. E hara takutoa I te toa taki tahe nare he toa taimano. My strength is not that of the individual, but that of the collective. And I know, and we know, that you will be an amazing collective. To our Year 13 students, thank you all for all that you have given to Waiopehu College, and you leave with our very best wishes for your future success. Your journey to adulthood is almost over. Those Waiopehu values and sense of family will stay with you forever. Carry them with you always and enjoy the future challenges and opportunities that come your way. Make sure you set lofty goals and be sure to chase your dreams. Remember what lies behind you and what lies before you are tiny matters compared to what lies within you. Be true to yourselves always. And finally, thank you to everyone that has contributed to 2021, and I want to leave you with one final message. I heard a great speaker called Stuart Pacini at a business event in Levin recently, and he talked about mindfulness and how it is so important to start your day the right way. This set me thinking, because look, I don't mind admitting that I have found this year quite challenging due to the impact of COVID and the constant worry about the effects on Aotearoa, on Levin, on Waiopehu College, as well as on my own family and friends in the UK, many of whom have had and now thankfully recovered from COVID. The trouble is, I was starting my day by picking up my phone and reading the news. And what do you think almost every headline is stating? Yep, COVID updates by the second, vaccination rates for each region, or alert level this and traffic lights that. But you know the headlines today are the same as last week, the same as last month, and the same as last year. We talk about feeding our bodies with good, healthy kai, which of course we now do every day with free and healthy lunches at Waiopehu. And we also talk about the importance of exercise. But I've realized it's also really important to think about how we feed our mind. I now do not read the news or look at social media in the morning. Instead, I'm trying to start with a bike ride, a walk, or a workout. I challenge you to think about how you feed your mind. You will find the news and social media updates you need to hear will still find a way of reaching you. And an American motivational speaker, Zig Ziglar, once said, "Your mind is a powerful thing. When you fill it with positive thoughts, your life will start to change." And that is the challenge I leave you with today. Fill your mind with positive thoughts and be kind to yourself and others around you always. I wish you all the very best and have a great afternoon. Nō reira, tēnā koutou, tēnā koutou, tēnā tātou katoa. Kia ora.
Thank you, Mr. Robinson. Our first item of this afternoon is a performance by the Barbershop Quartet.
Ooh, come fly with me, let's fly away, up and away. If you can use some exotic booze, there's a bar in far Bombay. Come fly with me, let's fly away. Come fly with me, let's float down to Peru. In Lama Land, there's a one-man band, and your tooth has flew for you. Come fly with me, let's take off in the blue.
Off in the blue, once I get you up there, where the air is rarefied,
we'll just glide.
Starry-eyed, once I get you up there, I'll be holding you so near. You may hear angels cheer, 'cause we're together weather-wise. It's such a lovely day. Just say the word and I'll beat those birds down to Acapulco Bay. It's perfect for a flying honeymoon, they say. Come fly with me, come on, let's fly away.
Come on, babe, let's touch the sky. Come on, baby, let's fly.
Thanks for that great performance. Our first set of awards tonight are the Dean's Awards, the announcement of our House Leaders for 2021, and the presentation of the House Trophy for the winner of the year-long House Competition. Our Deputy Principal, Ms. Ellen Spencer, will announce the awards, and our other Deputy Principal, Mr. Reichenbach, will present them.
The Dean's Awards recognise outstanding citizenship. They are awarded to students who consistently demonstrate our Waiopehu pride values, both in and out of class. These people achieve at or beyond expectations academically. They cultivate positive relationships with their peers. They have a high attendance. They have a really good pastoral record. And they have been involved in the extracurricular life of the school. Our Year 11 Dean's Award in 2021 goes to Jamie Lee Fuiano. Come up, Jamie. The Year 12 Dean's Award goes to Annalise Morris. Year 13, the award goes to Gabrielle Reid. Okay, let's give them one final. Okay, it's been another tough year of house competitions, but we're relying on Reiki's calculations here. I'm gonna question a couple. Fourth place, Oho. You know, I'm the maths teacher, he's not. Third place, Makaritu. Second place, this is where you might have good calculations, Blackwater, meaning our winners are Ōtaki. Can I have my house leaders up here? Can we have our Ōtaki house leaders up here, please? Done. The House Deans have had a really difficult job deciding who is going to lead their House to victory next year. This job has been ongoing for the last couple of weeks, and it really has caused some difficult conversations. I congratulate the following students who will take on the task, and it's a big task, of motivating and inspiring their House to victory next year. So, Blackwater House leaders for next year, Riley Cooper and Amahia Batterball. House leaders next year, Isabel Montague and Bella Watson. The winning house next year. Ōtaki House leaders, Ethan Devery and Hastings Rako. Last but not least, Makaurau House leaders, Ariana Harrington and Liam Preece. Well done to our new leaders. The next section of the ceremony is mostly about looking forward to next year. But before the announcement of the 2022 student leadership team, I'm going to invite Brinia and Tiaku to present their head student's address.
I ngā mana, I ngā reo, I ngā karanga maha. Kei te mihi, kei te mihi, kei te mihi. Ki ngā mate e haere ana koutou ki te taha o ngā tūpuna. Haere, haere, haere atu rā. Ka hoki mai ahau ki te hunga ora. E nā matua, e nā whanau, e nā paupau o te hapori nei. E nā kahuri i kōnei ana, nā te mea, nā te mate karuna. Kei te mihi, kei te mihi, kei te mihi. Ki oke hoa te tau, tukamakoru, turu. Ka te mai mātou ki te, tara, ki te ara teitei o te karaiti o Waiopehu. Kei te mihi, kei te mihi, kei te mihi. Ki nā ahunga o Waiopehu, kia kaha rā koutou ki te ako. Kia kaha rā koutou ki te whakawhanaungatanga o Waiopehu. Kei te mihi, kei te mihi, kei te mihi. Kia ora, I'm Tiaki and I'm proud to be in front of you speaking today. Coming into 2021, there's a lot of uncertainty. Though I am sure most of us are sick and tired of hearing about it, COVID-19 has once again massively impacted our school lives. Signing in, wearing masks had become the new norm. Planned events were cancelled, restricted, or postponed. We even had another three-week lockdown, or better known as a holiday, or online study. But through all the bad came the good. I really cannot thank each and every teacher and staff member enough for the hard work and effort you put in. Despite the circumstances, it was made clear why the school was so special. The Pihu Way really shone through. No matter the task or challenge, many hours were put into making this year a good one. Being head boy this year has been a big honour. I always like to think about who I've become and what the school has done for me. Looking back to my junior days, I was always a quieter kid who liked to observe. Speaking on stage seemed as impossible as removing the image of Raki and Speedos from my head. So today, to think that I am here standing in the spotlight, speaking to a crowd, still blows my mind. The head boy role has helped me develop many valuable life skills. I have met many new interesting people, and have been lucky enough to attend various events, such as speaking on Anzac Day, and even speaking to Jacinda Ardern herself. This role has taught me to go outside my comfort zone and experience new things, despite it being new and terrifying. So with that being said, I would like to leave a message to my successor. I hope you take on this role with everything you have. Wear the Pehu emblem with pride. Take on every opportunity available. Be you, as you were chosen for a reason. I would also like to acknowledge my fellow prefects, but especially the Hegel Brunier. Brunier and I have both been here since year nine. Though we didn't really cross paths till later on in our senior years, she is someone I have come to appreciate. I'm really grateful to have been able to experience the ups and downs of the many new and different experiences with her. Brunier is someone I can trust and rely on, who stays humble while doing nothing but the best for her peers. As we take our last stand as Hugh students, I would like to thank you for everything. I could not have wished for a better head girl to be on my side. I wish you all the best for the future, and I look forward to seeing you succeed. Now to my Year 13 peers. I would like to share the words of Drake. We started from the bottom, now we're here. Here, at the end of an adventure, we've made it to the next level, beyond the school gate. We are now the little fish in an ocean of opportunity. So I wish for you to take those opportunities and show everyone what you're made of. Cherish these times, as you don't know when the good old days will end. But most of all, remember me when you're rich and famous. Before I finish, I would like to say one last thank you. Thank you to Mr. Robinson, Rocky, and Ms. Spencer. I don't know how you put up with us sometimes. A thank you to the Board of Trustees for all the hard work you do behind the scenes. It doesn't go unnoticed. A thank you to each and every teacher, student, and person who makes a school Waiopehu. And last but not least, my parents, my siblings, my whānau. You're my driving force. Thank you. Nō reira, tēnā koutou, tēnā koutou, tēnā tātou katoa.
Ngā mihi nui ka koutou katoa ki te kura. Tēnei te mihi ki tō tātou ariki, nā nānei ngā mea katoa ihanga. Ki ngā tauira o tēnei kura e whai ana e mātauranga. Kia kaha, kia maia, kia manua nui. E ngā mātua, e ngā whānau, e ngā kaiako, tēnā koe e tō koutou aroha kia mātou. Kei te mihi, kei te mihi, he mihi nui nei. Taumai ki te waka o Tainui ki te whenua, ka pakiaki au ki rungi te maunga atahua o Tararua, e re reana ngā wai hoingo hokio, ko te mana o Ngāti Raukawa me Ngāti Tūwhare Toa e mihi ana, ki te marae tā katoa mai nei ko Ngāti Kuwaru. Tēnei au ko Brunia Pauranei. Kia ora everyone, it is both a privilege and an honour to be standing here speaking to you all today. It's honestly a surreal feeling that we're already in our final moments together after 5 whole years at this kura. What a journey this has been for each and every one of you. Taking a look back at year 9 and remembering our first days, it seems like only yesterday that I was making my way to my first class with my little 9W classmates ready and eager to learn. I know we all had different experiences, with some years being better than others, but it's comforting to know that without the struggles and sometimes continuous battles, we would not have gotten this far and made so many valuable memories with those that we encountered. It's important to acknowledge where we came from, as I feel that everything we go through in life is what shapes us to who we are today. Some friendships made from day one and others formed along the way. Regardless of when they started, I know for sure that a lot of them will never end. So for all of the laughs, tears, and lifelong memories, I am forever grateful. Speaking of memories, I'd like to share just a few of our very own Year 13 favourites. So Year 13 camp was definitely a highlight of the year, even though some things didn't quite go to plan. We all did our best to enjoy the sun, play some volley, and have a Menes jam session on our last night, as that was definitely one to remember. More memories were made throughout our time at Pehu with the opportunities to venture outside our school gates, such as zoo trips, the Europe art trip, social studies, geography, and PE trips, as well as that we can't forget Year 9 and 10 Activities Week. Some more highlights from our Year 13s over the years were Tournament Week, athletics, working hard on their house banner and cheerleading, dominating at annuals, and winning the finals of their sports season. As well as this, others enjoyed winning Stage Challenge in Year 9, Dance NZ Made, and participating in Rock Quest. While those are all very proud memories to look back on, we also have a few that are somewhat out of the ordinary, per se. This includes sneaking around the school at 10 p.m. wearing bee suits, becoming TikTok famous, and let's just say, making sherbet in Year 11 science class. Speaking of class, other memories made in our early year 9 and 10 core class and some made in our tutor groups will also be dearly missed. However, the best memories are made with your friends, as it was made quite prominent that hanging with the boys and making new friends was a highlight. Although I found a few of our year 13 favorite memories were leaving the school, I know there is much that you will miss when you get the chance to look back and are just eager to get your future started. Personally, my favorite memory from earlier this year was being chosen to attend the Māori Women's Leadership Summit in Auckland, Te Huihuinga a Wahine Māori. This conference was all about bringing together a wide range of wahine Māori from all ages, all regions, to talk about the underpinning issues affecting our rangatahi, as well as Māori as a whole. I'm mentioning this event as it has opened my eyes to the endless possibilities that we are all able to accomplish, even as young people. Without this opportunity, I would have never gotten the chance to engage with so many empowering women and learnt about the changes I am able to make in my position moving forward. This has allowed me to find my passion, my purpose, and my why. So for me, this one was more than just a memory, but an open door to the person I aspire to be. To be able to lead and be an example for you all definitely has its challenges that most of you on exec or in some kind of leadership position knows how it can weigh on you at times. Even for the year 13s tackling level 3 this year and trying to figure out what you want to do in the future, or even who you want to be, it can feel like the weight of the world is resting on your shoulders. However, with the support and guidance from family, teachers, peers, and friends, you can find comfort in knowing that everyone wants you to succeed and has your best interest at heart. E hara taku toe te toa takitahi, engari hi toa takitini. My success is not my own, but from many others. I believe this whakatauke perfectly entails the importance of surrounding yourself with those that will lift you up and help you to grow in ways that allow you to flourish. From this, I would like to give a massive thank you to Mr. Robinson, the SLT, as well as all of the teachers for guiding us through this journey, as well as individuals. We appreciate how you always find the time to make sure we're on the right track and taking the right steps towards our goals. I'd also like to acknowledge our amazing Deputy Head Students, Ortiz and Elijah, for always doing whatever you can to support Tiaki and I and lend a helping hand to any one of us on exec. And for that, I will always be grateful. To my talented exec team of 2021, I am so thankful that we got the opportunity to work together and each grow in our own ways. I know that each and every one of you will be extremely successful in your future endeavors. And to my bestie Tiaki, where do I start? I'd like to thank you for the continuous passion and hard work you bring to the team and your role. Even when we were thrown a million different obstacles, we always found a way to get over them and get the job done to our best ability. I always knew you were going to do great things with your drive for excellence and your hard work in everything you accomplish. There's always something new to learn from you, as you always seem to know it all, but I appreciate everything you do and wish you so much luck for whatever the future holds. To my family, who've always pushed me to do my best, and my friends who've supported me since day one, kei te mihi, I wouldn't be here without you guys. Now to the up-and-coming head students and exec team, I want to leave you with some wise words. Expect the unexpected. Always be ready for anything to come your way, but know that things are going to work out better than you imagine. Give everything a go, grasp a hold of every opportunity that you're presented with, feel the fear, and do it anyway. Lastly, to my year 13 sitting there waiting patiently for this all to be over, this is it. It's been a roller coaster, but we made it. I just want you to take a second to really appreciate those beside you and take in the final moments that we have with each other. Who would have thought this would all come around so quickly? I want you to be proud of how far you've come and take pride in your ability to get to where you are today. Even through 2 years of COVID, cancelled events, tournaments, and online school, you're still here doing your best and finishing what you started. Your presence does not go unnoticed, and I'm grateful to be a part of such a kind-hearted group of people. I'll definitely miss the laughs in class, the crazy games of mafia, and the sea of beautiful familiar faces. This may be the end to our young high school chapter full of lifelong memories, but what's to come in the future will be even better, I'm sure of it. Thank you all for an amazing year. Nō reira, tēnā koutou, tēnā koutou, tēnā tātou katoa.
I've got the very difficult task of following two amazing speeches from our head students. Can we just give them one more acknowledgement of that? Thank you. Well done. Okay, so kia ora, Brenia and Tiaki are going to remain with me because now we present each team member of our new student exec with their badges, and they will also pass their punamu on to their successors. So, could I firstly ask, please, the whole of next year's Naumanakura student leadership team to please gather by the stairs. And that is, in case you've all forgotten, Muniala Aleki, Cassidy Bell, Kyla Brune, Caitlin Burberry, Oliver Easton, Carly Ahuritapa-Williams, Amber Hudawai, Hannah Kerens, Maya Paulini, Eli Pratt, Charlotte Schlois, Sian Talea, Eneti Tofa, and Keandra Tohil. Okay, are we ready to announce the team? So first of all, one that we may already know is our Manukura Mangai Puari, our student board rep, who also receives the Darren Hughes Cup for Student Representative on the Board of Trustees, and that goes to Charlotte Schlois. Next, we have Manukura Hawara, and this is a joint position. The second position will be announced in a moment. But firstly, we award this to Kalia Horitapa-Williams, Head of Wellbeing. Next, Manukura Hakinakina, our sports leader, and also our Manukura Kaitiaki Portia, our treasurer, both going to Oliver Easton. Joining Oliver and leading sports will be another Manukura Hakinakina. Congratulations to Amber Hudawai. Now this year we are appointing two people to the position of Manukura Toi, our arts leader. The first is to performing arts, and that goes to Keandra Tohill. And the second arts position is to visual arts. Congratulations to Cassidy Bell. Next, we have Manukura Ahurea, our cultural leader. Many congratulations to Sian Telea. I said earlier that there were two people being appointed to joint Manukura Hawara to well-being. You've already heard and met Carly Ahuritapa-Williams, but now we meet the second, and she will also be the Manukura Hekeretari, our secretary, and that is Kyla Brune. Manukura Mātauranga, our academic leader, following in the footsteps of her brother. Congratulations to Muniala Aleki. Manukura Whakakako, media and communications leader, goes to Maya Paurini. Nothing awkward about that, was there? Right. Pototoko. We're now getting down to the serious end of the announcements. These are our deputy head students. And this year we've decided that both of these students are also going to be joint head of events. Our deputy head students for 2022, give it up please, for Caitlin Burberry and Eli Pratt. So that leaves just two. So no surprises. And let's hear a massive round of applause for very well-deserved Po Manukura head students. This year, 2022, will be Hannah Kerins and Eneti Tofa. Students just handing over their punamu for 2022. Congratulations to Eneti, to Hannah, and to the rest of our student execs 2022. If you'd like to all pause together, just so we can get some really cool photos before we disperse. Thank you, Mrs. Lamont. Congratulations. I'll now hand you back to your head students, Tiaki and Brenia.
Next, we'll celebrate the Year 11 Academic Awards. Ms. Donna Price, Dean of Makaritu House, will announce the awards, and Ms. Carlene Rovan, Māori Dean, will present them.
Good afternoon. We'll be calling our Academic Award winners up in groups. We'll hold our applause until the whole group has received their awards, then we'll clap them as a group. Can the first group please start their to make their way forward to the stage, please. Letia Tepu, Attainment Mathematics, Attainment Science. Zara Westerby, Attainment English, Attainment Physical Education, Attainment Japanese. Jeremy Healy, Attainment Sport and Leisure, Attainment Computer Aided Design, Attainment Mathematics. Michael Burns, Attainment History, Attainment Japanese, Attainment Physical Education. Hani Ula, Attainment English, Attainment Mathematics Foundation, Attainment Technology Construction, Attainment English as a Second Language. Florence Mark, Attainment Art, Attainment Mathematics Foundation, Attainment English, Attainment English as a Second Language. Ethan Devery, Attainment English, Attainment Science, Attainment Physical Education, Attainment Mathematics Advanced, Attainment History. And Ellie Burton, Attainment Dance, Attainment Drama, Attainment English, Attainment Mathematics Foundation, Attainment Fashion and Textiles. Lucas Selby, Attainment Digital Technology, Attainment History, Attainment English, Attainment Mathematics, Attainment Sport and Leisure Studies. Liam Prius, Outstanding Achievement Digital Technology. Tamatia Montez, Outstanding Achievement Dance. Peter Donnelly, Outstanding Achievement Sport and Leisure Studies. Kat Machuka, Outstanding Achievement Music. Emma Conway, Outstanding Achievement Drama, Attainment English. Kenneth Hollow, Outstanding Achievement Japanese, Attainment Mathematics Advanced. And Emma Haig, Outstanding Achievement English, Attainment Science, Attainment Business Studies. Jamie Walker, Outstanding Achievement History, Attainment English, Attainment Mathematics Advanced. Jamie Lee Fionnell, Outstanding Achievement History, Attainment Science, Attainment English. Emily Ballack, Outstanding Achievement Dance, Attainment History, Attainment Mathematics Advanced. Lavalea Fanotti, Outstanding Achievement Health Studies, Attainment Physical Education. Jessica Lawson, Outstanding Achievement English, Attainment History, Attainment Mathematics, Attainment Science. Roman Fryer, Outstanding Achievement History, Attainment English, Attainment Mathematics Advanced, Attainment Japanese. Liam Bryers, Outstanding Achievement English, Outstanding Achievement History. And Cassie Yates, Outstanding Achievement English, Attainment Science, Attainment Physical Education, Attainment Mathematics Advanced. Liam Anderson, Outstanding Achievement English, Outstanding Achievement History. Ollie Forth, Outstanding Achievement Mathematics Advanced, Outstanding Achievement Technology Engineering, Service to the Coffee Hut. Georgia Cruz, Attainment in Art, Attainment in English, Attainment in Mathematics, Attainment in Science, Attainment in Architecture, Service to Technology and Service to School Catering. Megan Guilford, Attainment Mathematics Advanced, Outstanding Achievement English, Outstanding Achievement History, Principal's Award for Excellence. Kyla Sadlier, Outstanding Achievement Art, Outstanding Achievement English, Attainment Science, Attainment Mathematics Advanced. Chad Goldie, Outstanding Achievement English, Outstanding Achievement History, Attainment Mathematics Advanced, Attainment Japanese. Amelia Wallace, Outstanding Achievement Business Studies, Outstanding Achievement Health Studies, Attainment Science, Attainment Mathematics Advanced, and Attainment English. Tawera Broughton-Hercombe, Outstanding Achievement Digital Technology, Outstanding Achievement Computer-Aided Design, Attainment Architecture, Attainment Mathematics Advanced, Attainment English. Gemma Dowd, Outstanding Achievement Mathematics Advanced, Outstanding Achievement Fashion and Textiles, Attainment English, Attainment Food and Nutrition, Service Coffee Hut, Service Science. Ariana Harrington, Outstanding Achievement English, Outstanding Achievement Food and Nutrition, Outstanding Achievement Fashion and Textiles, Service to the Coffee Hut, Service to the Science Department, and a Principal's Award for Excellence. Gina Huang, Attainment in English, Attainment Mathematics Advanced, Outstanding Achievement Business Studies, Outstanding Achievement Japanese, and Outstanding Achievement Science. Stevie Sayer-White, Attainment English, Outstanding Achievement Japanese, Outstanding Achievement Mathematics Advanced, Outstanding Achievement Physical Education, Outstanding Achievement Science, and a Principal's Award for Excellence. Kiana Sayer White, Outstanding Achievement English, Outstanding Achievement Geography, Outstanding Achievement Mathematics Advanced, Outstanding Achievement Physical Education, Outstanding Achievement Science, and a Principal's Award for Excellence. Kathleen Hamilton, Outstanding Achievement English, Outstanding Achievement Mathematics Advanced, Outstanding Achievement Science, Outstanding Achievement Social Studies, Outstanding Achievement Architecture, Principal's Award for Excellence, and the Top Academic Student at Year 11.
Thank you, Mrs. Price and Mrs. Roven. Congratulations to all of our Year 11 award winners. We will now move straight into the Year 12 Academic Awards. Mrs. Abby Quinn, Orho Dean, will announce the awards, and Mr. Patrick Pritchard, Pacifica Dean, will present them.
Good afternoon. Can the Year 12 award winners please start to make your way forward to the stage and your award groups? Kalei Araya Yates, Outstanding Achievement, Te Reo Māori. Ariana Bell, Outstanding Achievement, Fine Art. Charlotte Schlois, Attainment History, Attainment Mathematics Advanced, Service to Otaki House. Kyla Brun, Outstanding Achievement Art Design, Service to the School Ball. Cheyenne Medlin, Attainment English, Attainment History, Attainment Mathematics, Duke of Ed Bronze Award. Will Moore, Attainment Economics, Attainment English, Attainment Food and Nutrition, Principal's Award for Excellence. Christopher Brody, Attainment Computer Studies, Attainment Mathematics Advanced, Attainment Physics. Jake Reeves, Outstanding Achievement Computer Studies, Attainment Mathematics. Sage Elliott, Outstanding Achievement Fine Art, Attainment Business Studies. Oliver Easton, Outstanding Achievement Accounting, Attainment Economics, Service to Makaretu House. Bella Watson, Attainment Dance, Attainment Japanese, Attainment Mathematics. Callum Herring, Attainment Biology, Attainment Fine Art, Attainment Technology Engineering, Attainment Architecture. Muniala Aleki, Outstanding Achievement Art and Photography, Attainment Physics, Attainment Mathematics Advanced. Noah Waters, Outstanding Achievement Drama, Attainment Mathematics, Attainment Computer Studies. Isabel Montague, Attainment Art Photography, Attainment Biology, Attainment Chemistry, Attainment English, Attainment Mathematics Advanced, Principal's Excellence Award. Ethan Barclay, Outstanding Achievement Art Design, Outstanding Achievement Computer Aided Design, Attainment Computer Studies. Caitlin Burberry, Outstanding Achievement Social Studies, Attainment Tourism Studies, Attainment Mathematics, Attainment English, Service to Otaki House. Maya Podini, Outstanding Achievement English, Outstanding Achievement Fine Art, Attainment Mathematics Advanced, Service to the School Ball. Hannah Cairns, Outstanding Achievement Physical Education, Outstanding Attainment Architecture, Attainment Physics, Attainment Mathematics Advanced, Attainment English. Annalise Morris, Outstanding Achievement Fine Art, Outstanding Achievement History, Attainment Mathematics, Attainment Biology. Eli Pratt, Outstanding Achievement English, Outstanding Achievement Music, Attainment Mathematics Advanced, Attainment Physics, Service to Otaki House, Principal's Excellence Award. Keandra Tohill, Outstanding Achievement Art Photography, Outstanding Achievement Dance, Attainment Mathematics Advanced, Attainment English, Attainment Catering Skills. Taylor Marie Jensen, Outstanding Achievement History, Outstanding Achievement Catering Skills, Attainment Biology, Attainment Business Studies, Attainment English. Cassidy Bell, Outstanding Achievement History, Outstanding Achievement English, Outstanding Achievement Art Photography, Attainment Japanese, Attainment Fine Art, and a Principal's Excellence Award. Aneti Toffa, Outstanding Achievement English, Outstanding Achievement Mathematics Advanced, Outstanding Achievement Physics, Outstanding Achievement Music, Outstanding Achievement Architecture, Service to Otaki House, a Principal's Excellence Award, and the Board of Trustees Cup for Academic Excellence at Year 12.
Thank you, Ms. Quinn and Ms. Pritchard, or Mr. Pritchard. We'd now like to invite Ms. Brown, our Year 13 Dean, to celebrate the 2021 Year 13 Leavers.
Yep. Okay, all Year 13s, this is our graduation part, so yep, thanks. Give them a little bit of time to get in their order. The wind in my hair, the salt in the air, no worries, no cares, and you're they're scheming. Escaped to the dunes to hide from the group, just want to spend time with you. Laying side by side with Catch a Fire on the radio. Yeah, we get so high because we ain't got no place to go. Never say goodbye, and you ain't never gonna be alone. The promise we made, promise we broke. But I remember that summer, oh, the taste of your lips while the sun went down, so sweet. And I could exist in that summer, oh, 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 oh. Close my eyes and get lost in the memory, and just drift away. Taste of my tears when they run down my face, yeah. Reminds me of all of the years and the dreams I've been chasing. Fueling the fire inside so the fears I can face. Cause mom and
so our Year 13, if everyone's nearly ready.
So you can knock me down. Don't stay on the ground.
So our class of 2021, Sione Aholoka, Elijah Bethan, Ashley Bailey, Toby Bland, Brock Bell Rabone, Erin Backlund, Joshua Burling, Kate Caroline, Emma Christensen, Elissa Cunningham, Caitlin Davis, Josh Dowd, Georgia Dustin, Oriana Inoka, Olive Ferguson, Keely Fielding Woodmass, Miles Harrington, Jamelia Hicks, Enya Himuana Highland, Tiaki Hidini, Adam Horitapa, Grace Valiupolo Iakopo, Dodawa Kotoawea, Octavia King, Jazz Kleb, just a little technical hitch, we'll get going in a minute. Cool. Praneet Kumar, Robbie McPherson, Ruby Marshall, Christine Matihaere, Rose Matthew, Flynn MacGyver, Martin Molilupe, Dontiang Odea, Billy Parko, Amai Paranihi, good boy Amai, Brunea Podini, Joshua Pepper, Rita Bolima, Mere Pofari, Gabrielle Reed, Shania Sales, come up, Shania. Good girl. Good girl, Shania. Storm Scott. Ashley Snow. Jack Snow. Molly Tabram. Jasmine Tamatia, Kagan Tonua, Impala Toru, Janice Toru, well done, love. Mikaere Timomo, Liam Tipping, Lani Turner Belden, Alyssa Vavi, Noah White, Waiata Barryball.
Hey guys, 5 long years for some of you and those who have joined us along the way. Can I present to you our Leavers Year 13 2021?
You can't walk as fast as me.
Now for the Year 13 Academic Awards. They will be read by Mr. Cameron Brown, Blackwater Dean, and presented by Mrs. Brown, Year 13 Dean.
Could we get the first group of Year 13 award winners to come forward, please? Jasmine Tamatea, service to the coffee hut, service to school catering. Lani Turner-Bowden, attainment, catering and hospitality. Oriana Inoka, attainment English. Mikaidi Tumomo, attainment technology construction. Noah White, attainment music. Kagan Tonor, service year 9 camp, service swimming sports. Enia Himeon Highland, service year 9 camp, service swimming sports. Liam Tipping, service year 9 camp, service athletics, service swimming sports. Billy Parko, service year 9 camp, service athletics, service swimming sports. Ashley Bailey, service year 9 camp, service athletics, service swimming sports. Storm Scott, attainment food and nutrition, attainment business studies. Christine Matehaere, service year 9 camp, service swimming sports, service athletics, service Oho House. Gabrielle Reed, attainment health studies, attainment physical education. Grace Fale'upolo Iakupo, outstanding achievement digital technology. Erin Buckland, Outstanding Achievement in Mathematics, Service to Makaretu House. Flynn McIver, Attainment Police Studies, Service Swimming Sports, Service Athletics, Service Year 9 Camps. Dontiang Ortia, Attainment Art Photography, Attainment Fine Art, Service to the Athletics. Joshua Burling, Attainment Sports and Leisure Studies, Attainment Technology Construction, Service to Athletics. Rose Matiu, Attainment Chemistry, Attainment Mathematics with Calculus, Attainment Physics. Brock Bowl-Rabone, Attainment Sport and Leisure Studies, Attainment Technology Construction, Service Year 9 Camps, Service Swimming Sports. Toby Bland, Outstanding Achievement Mathematics with Calculus, Service to Ōtaki House, Service to Swimming Sports. Robbie McPherson, Outstanding Achievement Fine Art. Molly Tabram, Attainment Service, Attainment Social Studies, Outstanding Achievement Mathematics, Service to Ōhau House. Georgia Dustin, Outstanding Achievement Dance, Attainment Chemistry, Service to the School Ball. Octavia King, Outstanding Achievement English, Outstanding Achievement Social Studies, and a Principal's Award for Excellence. Martin Molelupe, Outstanding Achievement Police Studies, Outstanding Achievement Technology Engineering. Joshua Pepper, Outstanding Achievement Art Photography, Outstanding Achievement Fine Art, and Service to Athletics. Ruby Marshall, Outstanding Achievement History, Attainment Business Studies, Attainment Social Studies, Attainment Geography. Brunea Podini, Outstanding Achievement Health Studies, Outstanding Achievement Social Studies, Attainment Chemistry. Meriet Poufare, Outstanding Achievement Social Studies, Attainment Chemistry, Attainment English, Attainment Mathematics with Calculus, Attainment Physics. Peter Polema, First in Class Digital Technology, Service Ōhau House. Ashley Snow, First in Class Dance, Attainment Mathematics. Tiaki Hirini, First in Class Mathematics with Calculus, Attainment Physics, Service to the School Swimming Sports. Pranit Kumar, First in Class English as a Second Language, Attainment Financial Capabilities, Attainment Life Skills. Sioni Aholoka, First in Class Police Studies, Attainment Technology Construction, Attainment Health Studies, Service to Ōtaki House. Jack Snow, First in Class History, Outstanding Achievement Health Studies, Attainment Tourism. Caitlin Davis, Outstanding Achievement Fine Art, First in Class Fine Art, Attainment Mathematics with Calculus. Waiata Barrible, First in Class Fashion and Textiles, Attainment History, Attainment Fine Art, Attainment English, Attainment Catering Skills, and Service to the Coffee Hut. Olive Ferguson, First in Class Fine Art, Outstanding Achievement Fine Art, Outstanding Achievement Art Photography, Attainment History. Emma Christensen, First in Class Health Studies, Outstanding Achievement Social Studies, Outstanding Achievement Mathematics, Attainment English. Miles Harrington, First in Class Music, Outstanding Achievement Scholarship English, Outstanding Achievement Geography, Attainment Mathematics with Calculus, Principal's Award for Excellence. Josh Dowd, First in Class Business Studies, First in Class Architecture, Outstanding Achievement English, Attainment Scholarship English, Attainment Mathematics with Calculus. Elijah Bathin, first in class Mathematics with Statistics, first in class Physics, first in class Social Studies, Outstanding Achievement Chemistry, Outstanding Achievement Biology, Principal's Award for Excellence. Keely Fielding Woodmiss, first in class Chemistry, first in class Food and Nutrition, first in class Biology, Outstanding Achievement English, Outstanding Achievement Mathematics with Calculus, Service to the School Ball, Service to Otaki House, and a Principal's Award for Excellence. Jamelia Hicks, first in class Physical Education, first in class Geography, first in class English, Outstanding Achievement Scholarship English, Outstanding Achievement Mathematics, Outstanding Achievement Biology, and a Principal's Award for Excellence.
Can I please invite SLT to take over for the special awards? Sorry. We now have a final performance. This is a piano piece from the second movement of Beethoven's Moonlight Sonata, played by the talented Miles Harrington.
Thank you for that beautiful piece, Miles. We'd now like to invite Mr. Robinson, who will present the special awards for 2021, to come forward. First up is the Nathan Guy Trophy. Nathan Guy has donated this cup to be awarded annually to the top Year 13 English student. The recipient of the Nathan Guy Trophy this year is Jamelia Hicks. The Jared Bond Trophy goes to a student who has shown ability and service in the area of information technology. This year's winner is Rita Bolima. Social Science Award goes to a student who has shown excellence across a range of subjects in the social sciences. This year's recipient is our accomplished pianist, Miles Harrington. Senior Science Prize is awarded to the student who has shown excellence across a range of the sciences and who intends to continue their tertiary education in the science field. This year's winner, Kelly Fielding Woodmass. Yeah! Dave Herries Memorial Award. Dave's family has generously provided for an ongoing award to a New Zealand resident student for excellence in senior mathematics. This year we have joint winners, one for their achievement in calculus, the other for their achievement in statistics. Congratulations to Tiaki Hirani and Elijah Betham. Frank's Family Torch. This trophy is given in the spirit of Te Whare Āwhina. The recipient of this award has shown resilience and courage, demonstrating the quality of mind and spirit that has enabled them to face difficulties and achieve success beyond expectations. This year the torch goes to Torian Baggy.
It would appear that Torian is in absentia, so we'll award that to him later. Okay, the next award is the Courage Cup. This is awarded to a senior student who has had the courage to achieve to a high standard academically while facing and overcoming adversity. This year's deserving winner is Emma Christensen. The Pehu Pride Award, Te Whare Āwhina Trophy. This trophy is awarded to a student who has consistently demonstrated our college values. The proud recipient of this award is Ben Howarth. Mojo Coffee Awards. presented the best baristas in Year 12 and Year 13 catering hospitality courses. The winners are Jasmine Tamatia and Waiata Barrieball. The next group of awards are for students who excelled in food and nutrition courses in the senior school. There are five winners. BCE top student in Year 13 hospitality, Lani Turtabowden. Key Levin Award for food and nutrition Year 13, Keely Fielding Woodmass. Catering hospitality award Year 11, Taylor Marie Jensen. Key Levin Award for top student in Year 11 food and nutrition, Ariana Harrington. And Key Levin Award for food and nutrition Year 12, Will Moore. Can you come forward, please? The Kapa Nui Citizenship Award. This scholarship is intended for a Year 11 or Year 12 student who is an overall good citizen, has high attendance, is always prepared for classes, is respectful to teachers, students, and staff. In short, someone who always gives their best and consistently demonstrates the college pride values. The 2021 winner is Scott Van Geldof.
Photo Life Art Award. The winner of this award receives a camera kindly donated by Photo Life. Congratulations goes to Keandra Tohu. Paper Plus Levin Art Award. This award goes to a senior art student who has shown a high level of achievement during the year. The winner this year has displayed flair in painting. The winner of the Paper Plus Art Award is Caitlin Davis. Horowhenua District Council Art Award. We are very grateful to receive the generous support from the Horowhenua District Council. This award is $300 for a senior art student at the college. The winner this year, Olive Ferguson. The Altruza International Award is offered biannually to Waiopehu and Horowhenua Colleges. It goes to a student who has demonstrated a commitment to study, a willingness to work, and intends to study further at a tertiary institution. The winner of the Altruza International Award this year is Kate Carline. Colbert Cooper Award goes to a student who has shown the best entrepreneurial skills during the Youth Enterprise Scheme. The winner in 2021 is Josh Dowd.
Linda Sherlock Carver Bowl. This trophy was donated by the Pacifica Deans in 2019 and named after Linda Sherlock in recognition of her contribution to Pacifica students and their families. The bowl recognises academic achievement, cultural and sporting participation, behaviour and attitude, attendance, leadership and service to the school. The winner for a second year running is Sione Ahaloka. Whālai Pacifica Scholarship. The purpose of the scholarship is to recognise Pacifica youth who have been leaders and role models to other young people while fully participating in college activities. They must be planning on attending tertiary education next year. This scholarship is valued at $500 and I congratulate Rita Polema on winning it. UCOL Award. This is awarded to a student who has worked hard and balanced their school academic study while doing one day a week at UCOL. The winner of this has been attending the Cafe Skills Level 2 course. Congratulations, Charlotte Sluis. A new award, Kia Motors Levin Automotive Engineering Award. Kia Levin have kindly donated $500 to the student who has shown the greatest aptitude in the automotive engineering elective. The lucky winner of this award to be used for the purchase of tools is Alex Crichton. Alex has also been offered an apprenticeship at Keelevin. Congratulations, Alex.
The Levin Rotary Club has donated $1,000 in recognition of the service that our head students have given on behalf of the Student Council to the college this year. They have demonstrated sound leadership, contributing to our college community through active promotion of student activities and projects. They will also receive the Student Council Cup, Brinia Paurini and Tiaki Hirani. The Levin East Electrical Tertiary Study Award. Our thanks goes to Craig Proctor and Levin East Electrical for this award today. It provides for textbook purchases to a student or students of proven academic ability with the potential to succeed at tertiary level. This year it is a joint award and it goes to Georgia Dustin and Kelly Fielding Woodmass. Fred and Phyllis Sullivan Scholarship. This scholarship is worth $3,000. It is presented to students who demonstrate earnest endeavour, diligence, and perseverance. It is going to be shared this year, and each of the students will receive $1,000 towards their future studies. In 2021, the recipients of the Fred and Phyllis Sullivan Scholarship are Octavia King, Toby Bland, and Josh Dowd. The next award is kindly donated by Dr. Rachel Price, and it is for Women in Medicine. Dr. Price, it's no coincidence that her lovely mother is sitting to my left on the stage there. It provides $2,000 for a female student who will be studying first year health science at university. In 2021, the recipient is Mary Palfrey. It's time to recognise some other significant scholarships that have been awarded to some of our Year 13s, and I'd like to ask Tiaki, Brinia, Mary again, and Rose Machu to come forward to the stage so that we can acknowledge what you have. The Victoria University Totoweka Scholarship has been awarded to Brinia. The scholarship is worth $5,000, and it is awarded on the basis of academic merit, equity, leadership, and commitment to the community. Well done, Brinia. Rose is the recipient of the Edna Waddell Undergraduate Scholarship for Women in Technology and Engineering. The scholarship is also worth $5,000 and is offered to a student entering their first year of full-time study within the STEM field. Well done, Rose. Mary is the recipient of the Otago Māori Entrance Scholarship. This is awarded to a student who is attending Otago first year health science. This scholarship is worth $21,000. Tiaki has been awarded the Waikato University Ko Te Tangata Scholarship. This scholarship is also worth $5,000 and is awarded to a student who shows academic readiness and strong community spirit. In addition, he has been awarded the Maturanga Māori Scholarship. It is awarded to a student who is undertaking further study at Waikato University. The scholarship is awarded as part of the Three Waters Stimulus Fund. This scholarship is worth a whopping $50,000. Thank you very much.
The Gwyneth Shribley Scholarship. This is a new award, kindly donated by Gwyneth Shribley. This scholarship is to be awarded to a student going on to further studies or an apprenticeship in the field of engineering or a trade. It is to the value of $4,000 and has the potential to provide the winner again in their second year. The winner of this award is heading to UCOL to do an electrician's apprenticeship. Well done, Alyssa Vabe.
Omnian Studorium. This trophy is known as the Mark Minya Trophy. It translates to one who excels in all of his or her studies. This year's winner has been a member of the student executive. They have played rugby, volleyball, netball, was a joint recipient for sporting excellence in 2020. They already have NCA Level 3 and have been accepted into the Army for 2022. Congratulations, Oriana Renoka. Yeah.
Iti Kahurangi. Hei Iti Kahurangi Tai Whatiwha is awarded to a student who is proudly connected to and resonates the values of Te Ao Māori. A student who models leadership with humility, who promotes the use of Te Reo, who lives our school's pride values, and who has been a successful student in and out of the classroom. This year's winner has shown determination and tenacity. She is a role model in her tutor group and is known for her manaakitanga and empathy. She has completed Te Reo Māori externals and is a language component for her whānau, hapū, and iwi. She's also a tuakana within the college and is respected by many of her younger peers. The winner of this award this year is Impala Taru.
Robert Minard Cup. Robert Minard was the very first Ducks at the college in 1977. And in their generosity, his family set up a trust fund which provides annually a prize of $1,000 and the Robert Minard Trophy. This person is the runner-up to the College Ducks. This year's winner gained NCAA excellence at level 1 and level 2. They already have their level 3 NCA endorsed with excellence. This person is a valued member of our student executive and is the joint president of the Rotary Interact Club, the runner-up to the Ducks for 2021, Jamelia Hicks.
And now for our final award, Dux Literarum, top academic student at the college this year. The ultimate award this evening acknowledges the exceptional academic achievement of our top student, and it gives me great pleasure to announce the 2021 Dux, Elijah Bathan. Okay. As a Year 11 student, Elijah achieved Level 1 with overall excellence endorsed, gaining subject endorsements in all of his classes. He also took Level 2 coursework alongside his Level 1 study. Amidst COVID challenges, in Year 12, Elijah achieved both his Level 2 and Level 3 with overall excellence endorsements. This year, Elijah has continued to excel academically. To date, he has 148 Level 3 credits, 135 of these at excellence level. Elijah has also heavily extended his service to Waiopehu, serving as our 2021 Deputy Head Boy. Apart from this, Elijah has been offered $35,000 in tertiary scholarships to fund study at Waikato, Canterbury, and Waikato universities. However, sticking to his original goal next year, Elijah will attend Otago University with an outstanding Vice Chancellor's Excellence Scholarship selected by Otago's Vice Chancellor herself. This is valued at $11,000. He hopes to gain acceptance in medicine, studying to become either a neurologist or a paediatrician. Ladies and gentlemen, our Ducks for 2021.
Come on, 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 come on
just while Brenia and Tiaki return to the stage, we'll invite Fire Grace to come forward for a closing karakia.
Tēnā koutou, māku e whakakapi tō tātou tau, mō ngā tau te kaumātoru. I'm just going to close for our year for this beautiful celebration. Go ahead and see your dreams come true and do the best you can, and we're all backing you up. And for the next year, all the best. Have a great future. Ka nui te mihi, ka nui te aroha. Tēnā koutou. Me karakia tātou. Kia tau ngā mana ki tangā te rungarawa ki runga ki tēnā o tātou. Kia mahia te hua mā kihikihi. Kia toi te kupu, toi te mana, toi te reo Māori, toi ngā tikanga, tūturu āwhiti whakamaua. Kia tīnā, tīnā. Haumi e hui e, tā ai ki e. Tēnā koutou.
To end our ceremony, we now... Wrong one. Thank you, Fire Grace. I now invite you all to stand to sing the national anthem as the staff leave the stage.
Come on.
Okay.